A bad audio recording from a mobile phone can frustrate your plans to create a great video. And if you've tried to fix the problem using editing software, you'll know that it can take hours of unnecessary work. Well, stick around and I'll show you a fail-safe setup that can give you a quality audio recording, and it also can speed up your editing time without the need to synchronize separate audio tracks from a recorder. G'day, my name is Gary and you're watching the channel dedicated to take the confusion out of setting up your audio gear so you can concentrate more on using your talents to create great videos. Audio inputs on mobile phones have limitations because they're built into the device along with a lot of other electrically noisy parts. By connecting a microphone digitally to your mobile, that is to use the digital input instead of the headset connection, you can improve the chance of recording clearer sound because the processing of the audio is done outside. Zoom handy recorders like the H5 have a function you can select called audio interface, and this allows you to connect it to your mobile or a computer, and then you have the ability to plug in a whole array of microphones that you normally wouldn't be able to. These are the items that you'll need to connect it to your iPhone or your iPad: a Zoom handy recorder, the supplied USB lead, and a USB camera adapter. This is how you set up the H5 recorder. Switch on the recorder and press the menu button and move through the options and select USB. Now move the indicator and select audio interface. Select stereo and then select iPad. Now all that's left is to connect the lead. So join the supplied USB lead into the iPhone camera adapter and plug in the small USB plug into the recorder. And finally, connect the adapter into the digital or lightning socket on the iPhone. Now before you start recording, you need to select the mic input that you're going to be using and adjust the level of the volume. Remember not to raise it up too much because you're going to distort the recording. A good level is about minus 12 decibels on the meters. And using a device like the Zoom H5, you can take advantage of special functions like audio compression, but it might take you a little while to get used to setting that up. Record a trial to test your levels and then listen to that to see that there's no distortion and you're happy with that recording. The options are endless. You can use the stereo mics on the H5, or you can plug in a shotgun microphone to the XLR inputs, maybe even some handheld microphones, and you just select which one of these you want to use. It's as easy as that. If you'd like some more information, then check out the description below this video. And if you've got some suggestions that have worked for you, then share your ideas. We'd like to hear them. And if you've got any questions about this setup, then make sure you type them in the comments section. I'll try to reply as quickly as I can because your support's very important to me. And if this is the first time that you've watched a video from our channel and you'd like to learn more about sound gear in a simple and easy to understand format, then go ahead and subscribe so you can get a reminder when we upload more audio tips. You don't have to be a sound engineer to learn the basics of improving your audio. Sounds easy with simple audio tips. Until next time, I'll catch you later.